Hello and welcome to my Farsi class. Today we are going to learn a couple of more letters of Persian alphabet. The first one is Lam, which is the equivalent of L in English, and the second one is Vav, which is the equivalent of V but also O, U, and a couple of more sounds. You will see how this works. Okay, we are going to look at each of these letters separately along with a couple of examples. So make sure that you also review your other letters from previous videos because you will see other letters in these examples as well. Okay, so the first one, Lam, as you can see, kind of looks like L in English. A good example for that would be the word Gol, Gol, ending in lam, gol, which means flower. So as you can see, because here the letter lam has appeared at the end of the word, we are using the complete form. However, if it appears at the beginning or in the middle of a word, you will have to use the small version. As you can see in this second example, lale, lale, which is a type of flower, is tulip. Lale, and you can see that the letter lam in both cases has been written in the small version. Now the word lale technically ends in he, but the he is not pronounced. The he is mute, so lale. You don't say lale. Okay. Now, interestingly enough, this combination lam and aleph can also be written in these two other forms, which is quite confusing to some Farsi learners. Because when you look at these two things, you will think these are new letters. In fact, they're not. This is just a different way of writing la. Okay, now we're going to look at the second letter, which is vav. As we talked about it, it's the equivalent of v, u, o, and a couple of other things. And we're going to see how exactly it functions in different words. This one is a little tricky, so be patient with yourself because it will appear in different words and in each case it may have a different sound. Okay, the first example here we have vorud. Vorud. As you can see, vav appears here twice, but in the first case is the equivalent of v. And in the second case is the equivalent of U. The sound is U. So vorud, vorud. Vorud means entrance. So if you see this sign above a door, this means that's the entrance. Vorud. It's a very interesting case because you can see both versions of vav in one word, both sounds basically. So another good example is the word no, no. Again, here you see the letter vav, but now it sounds like o. No. No means type or sort. No. Ceno, what type, what sort. Okay, so please be careful. As you can see, this letter is tricky. Now, you're going to be even more surprised to see this example. This word technically is written with a basically, you know, with the vav. But in fact, what happens is, and I'm going to write it one more time so you can see it kind of more carefully. It is khahar. In fact, this vav is not even pronounced here. So we write it, but we do not read it. Very rare thing in Farsi. So basically, we have khahar, not Huahar, not Chavahar, nothing like that. It's just simply Chahar. We read it as if the letter Vav is not even there. Chahar. Now, this is really rare in Farsi. Usually we read what we write, we don't have extra letters, but just in like very small percentage of words, you will see cases like this, you know, when something is written but is not exactly pronounced. Let's just quickly review what we learned today. Lam and Vav. So Lam was the equivalent of L in English, Vav the equivalent of V, O, U, and a couple of other things, including It can be written, but not pronounced. So it can be basically mute. Okay, I think that's it for today. I hope you enjoyed this lesson. I know that the letter vav is a little tricky, so be patient with yourself. Remember to review the other videos that I made, and let's catch up soon. Chodafetz!